Hi everyone, and welcome back to the channel. It's the Poodle Mom again with the two toy poodles. In this video, we are going to be talking about our top 10 things to know about poodles, most especially toy poodles. This video will be perfect for future poodle owners. If you guys haven't made the decision of getting a poodle, but you do want to get one and you haven't decided, then this video might be of some help to you. We have also set timestamps on this video for your convenience, and you can easily access them in the description box below. If you guys will like the video, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up, and maybe you can subscribe and share the video. It would really help the channel. Without further ado, let's get to the video. All right, for the first one, poodles are very intelligent. As a matter of fact, poodles rank unofficially second next to border collies in the smartest breeds all around the world. They're exceptionally observant, most especially of humans.
So see, she can read my subtle movements. If I'm gonna pretend to go, she's not just gonna walk.
They're basically stalkers, and they read all your subtle movements, so you cannot trick them so easily.
So as you can see here, they can easily tell you that they have preferences, and they will tell you what they want.
Because they're the second most intelligent breed, it's only natural for you to assume that they are very easy to train. They're one of the easiest breeds to train, especially if you know what you're doing. When I got them, please believe me when I say that it only took me 2 to 3 days for me to completely potty train each of them, especially Summer over here. And I was completely shocked because I had a Chihuahua in the past. He was potty trained. The thing is, he would still mark the house occasionally, but it took a lot longer for us to potty train him compared to the two girls. They even know how to tell me when they need to go. Because of that, there are times they wake me up early in the morning because they need to go potty. But I'd take that any day. And I did teach them some tricks, but those are just useless, cute, and funny tricks.
If you're happy and you know it, roll around. If you're happy and you know it, and you really ought to show it. If you're happy and you know it, roll around.
Summer, where's the duck?
Yes!
Beanie, it's not yet your turn. Sit. Sit. Where's the duck?
Yes! Good girl!
I'm pretty sure I could teach them more, but the thing is, I'm lazy, so. Well, it's okay. So because they're naturally intelligent and very observant, poodles naturally need to be led and trained properly. Otherwise, they will take the leadership position and they will run the show in the house. And this is where the behavioral issues come in. Poodles are very smart, and they know if you're scared of them or not, or if you have a softer personality than them or not. Now, of course, it differs from dog to dog. For example, between the two girls, I think Bailey is the natural follower. This one, on the other hand, is a totally different story. We had a new helper who came in to join the house. She had a very soft personality, so she found the chance to get above maybe someone in the pack, and that's our helper. So she started challenging her. So you have to train them properly. Alright, number four. I'm not sure if it's the same for all poodles, but they become natural picky eaters because they know they can get away with it. I shifted the girls from kibble to all natural, either raw or I cook for them. And ever since then, they weren't as picky. But the thing is, again, it's different from dog to dog because, for example, this one here is my pickiest eater, but that one, I don't think she counts as a poodle because any chance she gets to steal her food, she will. All right, number five. So poodles come in three sizes, namely toy, miniature, and standard. I know everybody knows this, and it's easily found in Google. I included it because I feel terrible to see seemingly good breeders market their litters as mini toys. tiny toys, teacup toys, or micro teacup. And usually, these are the runts of the litter. So if you put that in a wild setting, meaning they're not domesticated, they're usually the pups that are abandoned by the mothers because they have the lowest chances of survival. These terrible breeders who just care for the sale over the health of the dog will just breed them for the sake of, sadly, and I know I sound cynical, for the money. With that premise, that's how I basically got Bailey. That's why I included this. I fell victim to that. It's not that I just regret my decision, but I could have done more research, I think. The thing is, I am lucky that I'm able to afford the vet bills, because that's how there are so many homeless dogs out there when owners can no longer take care of them. It's either the temperament or the health issues. They can't afford the vet bills anymore. And I'm not judging them because of that, but nonetheless, the consequences would really fall under the dog. They will just end up in shelters, and we have enough animals in the shelters. So please, 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 please do your research before you get a dog. Enough of the negativity. I know it's very serious, but okay, let's get to the next point. Before I get a lot of hate for, you know, buying a dog, let me explain first that my whole family has asthma, so we cannot have a dog that's not hypoallergenic or non-shedding. So that comes to our sixth point. Poodles do not shed, and they are hypoallergenic. What does that mean? Poodles not shedding is because they actually do not have fur. They have hair. Fur grows until a certain length and then will fall off. Meanwhile, poodles have hair, so much like humans, our hair will keep growing on and on and on. It will not fall off. That's why poodles need a lot of grooming attention. So they are also considered hypoallergenic. It's not the fur that people are allergic to or that causes asthma. It's actually the dog dander. So compared to other breeds, poodles produce very, very minimal to no dander at all. And with that, they don't smell. So if you don't like fur and you don't like shedding, then poodles are for you. With no shedding, it still comes at a price. And that price is grooming, as I have mentioned. Poodles are one of the most high-maintenance dogs when it comes to grooming. But I think they're also misunderstood in some ways, because when people consider grooming, they think of this. So when they think poodles, they think of this continental clip, the ones that are used for shows. And they think that the fur grows naturally like this, especially for the standard poodles. Reality check, guys, no. That's done by humans. You just shave the dogs to do that. It's just grooming. Grooming is definitely expensive because, like I mentioned earlier, they have hair. So they have to be clipped on a regular basis. Otherwise, it will mat. I personally brush my girls once every day, if not once every 2 days or every 3 days, but that's the most. Before, when I didn't know how to do maintenance grooming and a little trimming, I have to take them to the groomer every 3 weeks, if I'm not mistaken. But now I've lowered it down to every 2 months because it was breaking my bank. You need to consider grooming as a factor when you consider to have poodles. Unless you're okay with a poodle that's constantly shaved, then that's fine. Next point. So are they good with kids, or are they perfect for families? Top of mind, I think yes. But again, it boils down to training, proper training, and proper socialization. My dogs are perfectly good with kids and other families or any human that they meet. They love meeting people. That's because I socialize them at a very early age. So yes, they can be good with kids, but it comes down to training, because I've also seen poodles that are not good with kids. Now, among the three sizes, as far as I know, the standard poodles would be your best bet when it comes to kids, because they're the ones that are most patient. Out of the three breeds, the toy poodles would be the least when it comes to patience. But again, it can easily be fixed through training, much like the two girls that I have. Number 9. So poodles prefer people over other pets. This is not a fact. This is just my selfish opinion and my personal observation. I take my dogs to dog parks and the mall and pet-friendly places like beaches, lakes. We go hiking and stuff. My dogs will still greet other people, other animals if there are dogs, and they play with them for some time. But they will come back to me very, very quickly after saying hi, hello. That's it. This also means that since they're attached to people, they can be quite clingy. An example of this is Bailey. There was a time when she was so clingy, and it was my fault because I didn't know that I was actually making her more anxious because I was giving too much attention. So she learned how to howl. And I will show you in this clip over here. So this behavior is actually not good because it's an expression of severe anxiety, according to my trainer. And it was something that we needed to fix in the past. That's why I hired one. So yes, it can be fixed. But again, you have to give the right amount of attention depending on the dog, because it can easily lead to worse behavioral issues like this. All right, lastly. Poodles are a very generally healthy breed.
And they live for an average of 15 to 20 years, which is why I got them.
So I want a forever dog. That's why I've also shifted them from kibble to all natural. And I've been quite particular when it comes to their nutrition and stuff. And they do come with the usual problems. For example, for the standard poodles, the usual hip problems. For the small breeds, of course, the usual joint problems like laxating patella. That's common. Bailey actually has that. The vet said there's really nothing we can do. Like, she's not in pain or anything, so there's no need for any operation whatsoever. So we are just careful to prevent it from escalating any further. All right, that's it for our top 10 things. We hope you enjoyed the video and maybe learned something from it. If you have anything to add, please do comment down below, or if you have any questions, we'd love to hear your thoughts. That's it. So thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you for subscribing, and we will see you again next time. Bye.
So I hope that video was a lot better. We actually made the first one, and honestly, the audio was really bad, and I'm really sorry about that. That's why we decided to remake it.